China, let's face it, it's huge. 9.6 million square kilometres, the second largest country in the world, 5 autonomous regions and 1.35 billion people.
Yeah, 20% of the world's population lives in one country, but you probably already knew that. Well, today we're going to take a look at some things that maybe you didn't know about the country that's bigger, better and badder at everything.
China's already the biggest energy user in the world. To power the country, each year it takes 4 billion short tons of coal, that's half the world's total by the way, 4.6 trillion cubic feet of natural gas and almost 10 million barrels of oil per day and growing. In fact, from October, it'll overtake the US as the world's largest importer of oil. Unsurprisingly, this also makes it the world's largest emitter of carbon dioxide. Beijing's air quality index topped crazy bad earlier this year when it hit 755. 500 is supposed to be the highest it goes. China's a tale of two countries. It's had one of the fastest growing economies of the last two decades, but still has one of the highest number of people living in poverty. It makes everything and consumes just a fraction of it. The tech products, clothes, toys are all for export. And here's a fun fact. Did you know China makes around 85% of the world's fake Christmas trees? Yeah, it pissed the US off so badly they considered a Christmas tree tax. It might make sense though, because China has more Christians than Poland, almost as many Muslims as Saudi Arabia, and more Buddhists than, well, anywhere. It's got the highest number of children in the world and the highest number of elderly. And somewhere in between are the 618 million Chinese people that are fit for military service.
So we might want to stay on China's good side, which isn't necessarily easy because China ranks pretty high when it comes to human rights violations.
It executes three times as many people as the rest of the world combined and places thousands of others in unsanctioned prisons each year. Its military-style crackdowns in Tibet and Xinjiang have come under fire from rights groups, as have labour conditions. Still, China's our biggest trading partner, and as long as there are minerals in our grounds, it's probably going to stay that way for a little longer. At least until this alleged impending economic slowdown hits, then we're all screwed.